Good morning, Primary 5. How are you? Today we are going to continue or to complete Unit 2, which his name is Water Cycle. Water Cycle. Okay? Today we are going to take, of course, as a second lesson, we have the phonics. Okay? It's phonics time, yani. Okay. Our phonics today, that we bring verbs and we put at the end ion to change into noun. Okay, our phonics today that we bring verbs and we add at the end ion in order to change it into noun or to make a noun from a verb by adding ION. Okay. The first word is station. Station. Okay, station means the place where we can get on the train or bus. I go to the train station to get on a train. I go to the bus station to get on a bus. Or I wait for the bus at the bus station. Okay, so the station is the place where we can get train or a bus. Number two, fraction. Fraction, you took it in mass. Fraction means a part from number. The quarter, 1/4 is a fraction. 1/2 is a half. 1/2 is called a fraction. 1/8 is called a fraction. 3/4 is called a fraction. This means that it's not a whole number. It's not a full number. It's a part from the number. So the fraction means a part from a number. Like quarter, 1/4. Like half, 1/2. Like 3/4, 3/4. Okay, do you understand? Okay. Number three, direction. After me, direction. Direction means a sign that shows right, left, up and a down. Number three here, direction. After me, direction. A sign that shows right, left, up and down. Okay? Number four, all of them are very easy. Number four, invitation. Invitation. What's an invitation? It's a card. A card to invite someone for a party or a celebration or an event. Okay? A card you send to ask someone for a party. Not parties only, celebrations, events, important events. Okay? So I send a card to people to invite them for an event. This is called an invitation. So what is an invitation? A card. I have a party and I send the invitations to my friends. Okay? I have a party and I send the invitations to my friends to tell them to come to the party. Okay? So what is an invitation? A card you send to ask someone for a party. Number five, he tells you that invitation came from the verb invite. It ended with E. We canceled the E and we put ION. Okay? So, invite means to ask someone for a party or event or celebration. Okay? To ask someone for a party. I invite you. So, it means that I ask you to come to the party. Number six, collection. 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 Collection means a group of things gathered together. Like group of books, it's called a collection of books. Group of pens, a collection of pens. Group of markers, a collection of markers. Okay? So a collection means a group of things gathered together. Gathered means are together, means are together. Okay, to put things together, okay, to make a group. This group is called a collection. A collection. Okay, I have different books, so I have a collection, a different group of books, so I have a collection of books. I have some pens, so I have a collection of pens. Okay, is it easy? Okay. Pay attention to number 7. Protection. Protection. It came from the verb protect. Protect means to be safe. Okay? So, I wear a jacket in winter to protect myself from coldness or cold. Okay? Okay, what else? The jacket gives me protection. The helmet gives me protection. These examples are enough. Okay, so protection means keep something safe. Keep something safe. So I sit in a shelter for protection. I found a shelter for protection, which means that in the forest or in cold places or in hot places, I search for a shelter, a safe place for protection, to protect me from wild animals or from hot weather or from rain or from anything bad. So, protection means to keep something safe. Keep something safe. Okay, protection. Protection. Okay, number 8. Inspection. Inspection. Listen to me well. Again, inspection. 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 It's a noun which means checking things carefully. Checking things carefully. I am traveling to, I will give you examples. I am traveling to Alexandria. I bring a bag. I put my clothes. I put my important things that I will take with me. So, and every now and then I make an inspection over the bag to check that the bag has what I need. Do you understand? So, inspection means checking things carefully. Like me, I am your teacher. I am looking at your booklet. I am looking at your language book. I am looking at your class notebook. So, this means that I am making an inspection on your things. Okay? To check things carefully. Okay. Number 9. Action. Action. Action means doing something. Okay? Action. I am running. It's an action. I am walking. It's an action. I am talking. It's an action. I am exercising. It's an action. So action means doing something. Of course, it has other meanings. But here we want it as to do something, okay, doing something, okay, or action means something that has suspense, okay, and adventure, okay. Number 10, bud. Look here at this picture. The flower before it opened, okay, before it opened, it's called a bud. A closed flower. A closed flower, which means that it's not opened yet. Okay? So, bud means, bud, it's a noun, which means a closed flower. Bud, B-U-D, bud, a closed flower. The last word, we took it last time, sleet. Sleet, which means rain and snow falling together. Rain and snow falling together. Now, are the words easy? Let's revise the words again. Number 1, station. Station. I hope you repeat after me. Station means the place where we can get on the train or bus. The place where we can get on the train or bus. Number 2, fraction. Fraction, a part from number, a part from number. Number three, direction. Direction. A sign, the G silent. A sign that shows right, left, up and down. A sign that shows right, left, up and down. Number three. And number four, invitation. Invitation. A card you send to ask someone for a party. A card you send to ask someone for a party. Invite, a verb, invite, to ask someone for a party. To ask someone for a party. Number six, collection. Collection. A group of things gathered together. A group of things gathered together. Protection. 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 Keep something safe. Keep something safe. Inspection. 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 Checking things carefully. Checking things carefully, like I am looking at your booklet, seeing if you did your homework or not. Okay, this is called inspection. Number nine, action. Action, doing something. Action means doing something or adventure. Okay, number 10, bud. B-U-D, bud. B-U-D, bud. Means a closed flower. A closed flower. Number 11, the last word. Sleet. Sleet. Rain and snow fall together. Rain and snow falling together. Now, let's turn to our grammar today. We are going to revise two tenses together, past simple and past continuous. The past simple means action happened and finished in the past. So the past simple tense expresses an action happened in the past and finished, or an action happened and finished in the past. The form of the past simple tense, regular verbs and irregular verbs, which means we have two kinds of verbs. Verbs that take D-E-D, I-E-D, doubling E-D, and irregular verbs. For example, go, it becomes a went. Okay, so the past simple tense, it expresses an action that happened and finished in the past. The form of the tense, to know that we are in the past simple tense, what is the form of the verb? We have two forms. We have regular verbs. What is the meaning of regular? That the verbs take at the end D, ED, IED, or doubling ED. And the irregular means that the shape of the verb or the form of the verb is changed completely. Okay, like go, it became a went. Okay, keywords tightna. Yesterday, last ago, in the past, or any old time. Yesterday, last ago, in the past, or any old time. Old time means when I say 1666, it's past. When I say dinosaurs, past. When I say what? Ahmad Arabi, by example, this is means past. Okay, so when I say a character or someone or old date, this means a past. Okay, so I know now the keywords of the past simple: yesterday, last ago, in the past, and any old time. Any old time or any old date, this expresses that we are in the past simple tense. Okay, The second tense that we are going to take today, past continuous tense. Past continuous tense expresses what? Past continuous tense, action happened at a certain time in the past. Action happened at a certain time in the past. Do you understand? Certain time in the past. And when I say at 7 o'clock yesterday, this is means certain time in the past. Okay? Form بتاعت التنسي بتاعنا was or were plus verb ing. Was or were plus verb ing. So the past continuous tense, we have two verbs in the sentence. We put first was or were, and then we put verb ing. Okay? ماشي. We don't have, in this tense, we don't have specific keywords. Okay? But we can see at 7 o'clock yesterday morning, or a sentence with when and the past simple. Again, in the past continuous tense, we can't see a specific keyword. Okay? A helping يعني keyword. But we can see yesterday morning, yesterday evening, yesterday all day, at 7 o'clock yesterday, at 9 last week. This is called certain time in the past, okay? Or we may have a sentence with when and the past simple. Like when the bus came, this means that I wanted to put past continuous. When the light went out, this means that I'm going to put past continuous. When it started to rain, this means that I'm going to put past continuous, okay? The indications. Indicated sentences or phrases, which means that we are going to put our sentence in the past continuous tense. Okay, do you understand now the difference? Past simple tense, action happened and finished in the past. Keywords, yesterday, last ago, or any old date, or in the past. In the past continuous tense, action happened and continues. Okay? At a certain time in the past. Certain time in the past, like yesterday at 7 o'clock, at 3 o'clock yesterday, at 9 o'clock last week, when the bus came, when the light went out, when my dad arrived, when the doorbell rang, when it started to rain. Okay? Okay, our form in the past simple tense, regular verbs and irregular verbs. Our form in the past continuous was or were plus verb ing. Okay? So I must write first was or were, then I put the verb in the ing. Sorry, we put ing at the end of the verb. Now let's see our booklet, page 22. First, he is going to revise you, past simple tense. Okay. It refers to actions that happened and finished. Okay? Examples. I played tennis yesterday. They went to the park last Friday. He wrote a letter 3 hours ago. Do you understand? Do you remember? Okay. The form. First the subject comes, then the verb. Sometimes we have regular verbs and we have irregular verbs. Regular like played, moved, closed. Irregular like went, wrote, sat. Okay, you know them of course. Our keywords are yesterday, ago, last, and in the past. Yesterday, ago, last, and in the past. And I told you as well, any all the time. The negative case of the past simple tense. We have regular and irregular verbs, and we have only one verb in the sentence. So I need to put not in the sentence. Negative means to put not. So I have to bring a helping verb. What is the helping verb of the past verbs? The helping verb of the past verbs is did, D-I-D, did, okay? And in the negative, it became a didn't. Okay, I didn't visit Luxor. I won't say something. I have only three helping verbs to our main verbs. Don't, doesn't, didn't, or do, does, and did. With these three helping verbs, the verb becomes infinitive. After don't, after doesn't, after didn't, the verb becomes infinitive. After do, after does, after did, the verb becomes infinitive. Okay? So here, I, the example was, listen to me well, the sentence was, I visited Luxor, and he wrote to me to put not. So, I didn't visit Luxor. I didn't visit Luxor. The second example, he saw his friends yesterday, put not. He didn't see his friends yesterday. He didn't see his friends yesterday. Okay, the past continuous tense. The second page, okay? Listen to me. It refers to actions that took a time in happening in the past. This means continuing in the past, okay? And to express about the actions happened in the past and one of them stopped the other. Here he means when we have when and while, okay? There was an action continuing, and some action cut the action and stopped this continuous action. Okay, like I was running, the bus came. So I was running bus continuous. It was continuing in the past. What stopped me? That the bus came. So I was running when the bus came. I was riding my bike when I fell down. What stopped riding my bike? That I fell down. Okay? So we have a continuing action and an action that stopped it. Okay? Okay. Our form is subject plus was and where plus verb A-I-N-G. Okay, in the negative case, here we have was and where. So was and where are the helping verbs. So we put not after was and after a where. So in the negative, wasn't and weren't plus verb ing زي ما هو. Okay? I wasn't studying English. They weren't doing their homework. So we don't do anything to the verb ing. We just put not after was and after a wasn't. Okay? Here, ba. While and when. Our joining words. Joining means that I have two sentences and I want them to be one sentence, so I put a word to connect them. Okay? Like when and while. While, it came capital at the beginning of the sentence and it can be small in the middle of the two sentences. Okay? So, while comes after while, past continuous, the long verb, لو was or were plus verb ing. And the second sentence is past simple, اللي هو past simple بتاعنا العادي. Okay? While, but when while comes in the middle. So before while, we have past simple, then we write while, then we write past continuous. Here are the examples. While mom was cooking, my father came. So mom was cooking is past continuous, and my father came, past simple. So after while comes, past continuous, and the second sentence is past simple. My father came while mom was cooking. So here, when we wrote while in the middle, we made a cross, okay? So we put my father came first, then we put while and mom was cooking, okay? When, after when, it's the opposite, ba. Okay? When plus past simple and past continuous. When plus past simple and the second sentence is past continuous. So after when comes past simple. لو the action that stopped the long action. Okay? And the second sentence is past continuous. طب if when comes in the middle, so before when, we put past continuous, then we write when, then we write past simple. Here, again, when is the opposite of while, okay? After when comes past simple, and the second sentence is past continuous. Here we have examples. When the telephone rang, I was watching the film. So when we want to put when in the middle, we make a cross. I was watching the film when the telephone rang. Do you understand? Okay. I want to say something before switching from this page, that I have other joining words, okay? Like while. I have while, as, just, as. I have while, as, just, as. While, as, just, as. After them comes past continuous. After while, and as, and just, as. I write a past continuous. So after while, as, just, as, I write past continuous. Okay. Let's see these examples. How to switch from past simple to past continuous and the opposite. Okay, here, Mona played some sports yesterday. This is past simple. I want to put yesterday morning. Here I have certain time in the past. I have yesterday morning, not yesterday only, yesterday morning. This means that I want to put past continuous. Past continuous means was plus was or were plus verb ing. The answer is Mona was playing some sports yesterday morning. Mona was playing some sports yesterday morning. Okay, Mona is singular, it takes a was. The second example is I was riding a bike. I was riding my bike at 3 o'clock last week. Okay, this is past continuous. How do I know was riding? And at 3 o'clock last week. At 3 o'clock last week, certain time in the past continuous. So I wanted to put only last week. So I want to change into past simple. The answer is I cancel was, I cancel ing, and I return the e. Okay, verbs that ends with E, we cancel E and put ING. So when I cancel the ING, I return the E. And cancel at 3 o'clock last week. And the answer will be, I rode my bike last week. I rode my bike last week. Ride, R-I-D-E. It's an irregular verb. In the past, it became rode. So the answer is, I rode my bike last week. Let's see these exercises. Choose. We can go to the space to catch the train. We catch a train and the bus from the station. So we can go to the station to catch the train. Number two, I'll make a party next week. I'll send invitation, direction, fraction, card to my friend. I send invitation. When I have a party or any event, I send invitation. Number three, they build shelter. Shelter, I said shelter. We make shelters for protection, inspection, or collection from the rain. Of course, protection. So they build the shelter for protection from rain. Okay, it keeps me safe from a rain. After while, verb past continuous, was or were plus verb ing. So while they were studying, comma, the light went out. While they were studying, of course. He was riding a bike, past continuous. After when, past simple. When he fell, was falling, fall down. Where is the past simple? Fell, F-E-L-L. The infinitive is fall, F-E-L-L. And the past is fell, F-E-L-L. So, he was riding a bike when he fell down. Okay. The rewrite. Number one. Ali played tennis. He fell down. As I told you that as and while and just as, they are joining words that past continuous comes after them. يعني comes past continuous comes after the is and the just is and the why. Okay. Ali played tennis. He fell down. The answer is here. Pay attention to this sentence. The answer will be Ali fell down as he was playing tennis. Of course, the first sentence is the past continuous sentence, and the second will be as it is past simple. We want to change it, okay? But here as is small, so it comes in the middle, and after as comes the past continuous. So we are going to make a cross. Pay attention here with me. Pay attention here with me. If I have a name and a pronoun, so when I'm going to make a cross, the name is kept in its place, first place, which means that I can't say he fell down as Ali was playing tennis. It's odd. Okay? When I have a name, the name comes in the first sentence. حتى لو بقية things اللي وراها مش هيجوا معاها أو هنعملهم cross. زي الانسر كده علي fell down as he was playing tennis. Do you understand? So here we made a cross, but we kept علي in its place and he in its a place. The second one, they cooked lunch, their father arrived. Where is the action that stopped the long action? Their father arrived. Okay, they were cooking and what stopped the action? That their father arrived. Here he wrote to you when small. So when will come in the middle. And after when? Past simple. Here is the answer. They were cooking lunch when their father arrived. They were cooking lunch when their father arrived. Number three. I was eating fish yesterday at 8 o'clock. This is past continuous. I want to put yesterday only, so I will change it into past simple. The answer is I ate fish yesterday. I ate fish yesterday. Number four, Ala and Ala, plural now, drank tea yesterday, past simple. I need to put yesterday at 8 o'clock, past continuous. So Ala and Ala were drinking tea yesterday at 8 o'clock. Why, miss, we wrote were? Because Ala and Ala are plural. So they take were. Okay? So Ala and Ala were drinking tea yesterday at 8 o'clock. Thank you for listening to me. I hope you enjoyed and you understood. Have a nice day and thank you. Bye-bye.